Good morning. It's Thursday, August 13th, and this is Top Story. Joe Biden has chosen his fighter. It was one of the least splashy political announcements in recent memory, with Biden largely campaigning from home and official word coming out over Twitter. Biden's choice and Harris's acceptance. Well, here are the stats. Kamala Harris is the first black woman major party VP candidate. Her selection fulfills Biden's promise to name a woman running mate and the widespread expectation that he'd choose a person of color. Biden and Harris appeared together publicly yesterday for the first time as the team that will face President Trump and Vice President Pence in November. Harris had been among nearly 30 Democrats who fought to become the presidential candidate. Harris was considered a major candidate, but she couldn't attract enough fundraising and had to quit the race in early December. Before she did, though, she criticized Biden in deeply personal terms. She called attention to Biden's opposition 5 decades ago to federal busing to integrate racially segregated public schools.
On that issue, we could not be more apart, which is that the vice president has still failed to acknowledge that it was wrong to take the position that he took at that time.
On the World and Everything in It podcast, political analyst Kyle Condict cites a long history of former bitter political foes coming together in a general election.
Obama-Biden was actually one of those in 2008, and also the Ronald Reagan-George H.W. Bush ticket in 1980 and 1984, which is one of the most successful tickets of all time. Reagan and Bush were sort of at each other's throat in that 1980 primary.
Also on today's full World Watch show, former Vice President Joe Biden, now presidential candidate, chooses a tough rival as his own VP. Plus, an earthquake early warning system based on billions of smartphones could buy precious seconds. And we'll take a look at political conventions. There's much more content on our website, worldwatch.news. We've got our full 10-minute program. Plus, you'll be able to watch standalone feature stories or view the newscast to get a quick snapshot of the news of the day and continue on your way. Make sure you go there right now. You'll sign up for worldwatch.news. And remember, whatever the news, the purpose of the Lord will stand.